My dear cadets, welcome to you all at the virtual arena of Borishal Cadet College. I am Joydeep Mondol, lecturer, Department of Mathematics, Borishal Cadet College. Dear cadets, first of all, I want to see you how to put on, use, take off, and dispose of a mask. First of all, before putting on a mask, wash hands with alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water. Second, cover mouth, nose with mask and make sure there are no gaps between your face and the mask. Avoid touching the mask while using it. If you do, clean your hands with alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water. Third, replace the mask with a new one as soon as it is damp and do not reuse single-use masks. To remove the mask, remove it from behind. Don't use touch the front of mask. Discard immediately in a closed bin. Wash hands with alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water. Dear cadets, can you imagine in a market there are few members without whom a market scene cannot be complete? Let's see who are they. Dear cadets, here you can see a shop. Here is a shopkeeper. You have heard the word wholesale, shop, retailer. That is, all are happen if there are two person. One is seller, another is customer. And among these two person, the profit and loss always occur. So dear cadets, today my topic is profit and loss. The learning outcomes. At the end of my class, you will be able to explain the profit and loss, solve related to the profit and loss, solve real life problems. The key points: cost price, selling price, profit, loss. Then, first of all, what is cost price? The amount paid for a product or commodity to pass, it is called a cost price, also denoted as CP, that is cost price. Then selling price. The amount for which the product is sold is called selling price. It is usually denoted as CP, also sometimes called a sale price. Now, profit and loss. First of all, we will learn what is profit. If selling price is greater than cost price, then selling price minus cost price is profit. Now loss. What is loss? If cost price is greater than selling price, then cost price minus selling price is loss. So dear cadets, we have already learned what is the cost price, what is the selling price, what is the profit, and what is the loss. Now we will solve some problems related to this. The problem is, a shopkeeper has bought 1 kg of apples for taka 100 and sold it for 120 per kg. How much is it profit he got? Let's start. Cost price for apple is taka 100. Selling price for apple is taka 120. So profit gained by the shopkeeper is profit P equal to selling price minus cost price, that is 120 minus 100, that is 20 taka. Now another problem. An orange seller bought 100 oranges for taka 1000 and sold them for taka 1200. What is his profit? Solution. Let us start. The cost price of 100 oranges is taka 1000. The selling price of 100 oranges is taka 1200. So here we see that the selling price being more than the cost price, so it is profitable. That is, profit equal to selling price minus cost price. So selling price is 1200, cost price is 1000, so the profit is taka 200. Therefore, the required profit is taka 200. Another problem, a shopkeeper bought 1 sack of 50 kg of rice at taka 1600. Due to reduction of price of rice, he sold it taka 1500. What is his loss? Solution. Here, the cost price of 1 sack of rice is taka 1600. And the selling price of 1 sack of rice is taka 1500. Therefore, we see that the selling price being less than the cost price, the shopkeeper bears a loss. That's why the loss equal to cost price minus selling price, that is taka 1600 minus taka 1500. So taka 100. So the required loss is taka 100. Now, another problem. If 15 ball pens are bought at taka 75 and are sold at taka 90, what is the percentage of profit? So first of all, here we see that the cost price of 15 ball pens is taka 75 and the selling price of 15 ball pens is taka 90. So here we see that selling price being more than the cost price, so it is profitable. And what is the profit? Profit equal to selling price minus cost price. To know that the selling price is taka 90 and the cost price is taka 75. Then if we subtract this to 1, then we get 15. So we see that for 75 taka profit is 15. Because boys, profit or loss, whatever it may be, everything has to be counted, calculated based on the cost price. So in taka 75, this is the cost price. The profit is taka 15. In taka 1, the profit is taka 15 by 75. In taka 100, the profit is taka 15 into 100 divided by 75. That is, after calculating this portion, we get taka 20. So what is the required profit? The required profit is taka 20%. Now, another new problem. A fish seller bought 4 hilsa fishes at taka 1600 and sold his hilsa fishes at taka 350. What is the percentage of his profit or loss? Let us start. The price of 4 hilsa pieces is taka 1600. So price of 1 hilsa pieces equal to taka 1600 divided by 4, that is taka 400. Again, the selling price of 1 hilsa piece is 350. There the selling price being less than the cost price, so there is a loss. And we know loss equal to cost price minus selling price, so taka 400 minus taka 350, we get taka 50. Again, for taka 400, that is the for taka cost price, there is a loss of taka 50. So for taka 101, there is loss of taka 50 divided by 4. So for taka 100, there is a loss of taka 50 into 100 divided by 400, then calculating this on, we get taka 25 divided by 2, that is 12 and half. So loss is 12 and half percent. I think all of you have understood it. Then problem. An XLR buys 5 dozen of eggs at the rate of taka 100 and on per dozen and 6 dozen at the rate of taka 90 per dozen. What should be the selling price if he wants to gain taka 3 per dozen? It is that cost price of 1 dozen of eggs is taka 100 and on. So cost price of 5 dozen of eggs is taka 100 and on into 5, that is taka 505. Again, cost price of 1 dozen of eggs is taka 90. So cost price of 6 dozen of eggs is taka 90 into 6, that is 540. So we see that cost price of 5 dozen and 6 dozen, that is 5 plus 6 dozen, that is 11 dozen, will be taka 505 plus 540, that is 1045. So what is the average cost price? So the cost price of 1 dozen of eggs must be 1045 divided by 11, that is 95, and this on is the average cost price of 1 dozen of eggs is 95. So what we got? We have got that on an average, the cost price of 1 dozen of eggs is taka 95. Now, for profit of taka 3 per for each dozen of eggs, the selling price equal to taka 95 plus 3, that is taka 98. If 1 dozen is sold at taka 98, the egg seller gets taka 3 as profit. I think all of you have understood it very well. Another problem. Nabil bought 2 cases of sandesh at the rate of taka 2250 per kg from a sweet shop. If the rate of VAT is taka 4 per 100 taka, how many taka did he pay to the shopkeeper? Let us start. The price of 1 kg of sandesh is taka 250. Therefore, the price of 2 kg of sandesh is taka 215 to 2, that is taka 500. We have given that the VAT for taka 100 is taka 4. Therefore, VAT for taka 1, it must be taka 4 by 100. So, VAT for taka 500 is 4 into 500 divided by 100, that is, if you calculate this on, then you get 5, then 4 into 5 equal to 20. So Nabil have to pay it taka 500 and plus 20, that is 520 to the shopkeepers. I think you have understood. So dear cadets, we have already discussed what is selling price, cost price, profit, loss, how to calculate percentage of profit, how to calculate percentage of loss, how to pay it, VAT, and etc. Now, if you have any problem, please ask me in your comment section. Dear cadets, now it is time to take home task. Your home task is, Maisha bought 15 meters red ribbon at the rate of taka 20 per meters. The rate of VAT is taka 4% and she gave taka 500 to the shopkeepers. How many taka will the shopkeeper return her? Second one, Mr. Roy is a government officer. He will go to India to visit religious places. If Bangladeshi taka 1 is equal to Indian 0.63 rupee, how much Bangladeshi taka would he need for Indian 3,000 rupee? I believe all of you will solve it. Dear cadets, at the very last time of my today's class, I want to say again some symptoms of coronavirus. People suffering from novel coronavirus have complained of mild to severe respiratory illness with symptoms of fever, cough, shortness of breath. Finally, I want to suggest you stay home and stay safe. Thank you very much.